Living in Indianapolis, obviously you got to see the TV program, which Bruiser's TV was a really strange situation. For a while in the 60s, and
Yes.
there's still some footage of this, they did TV tapings at the old Southside Armory.
Armory, yeah.
And they would air those, and it probably was that the same way when you first came in 70? Were they still doing that?
It was till I left.
They switched. Was it the switch came where they started shooting the Expo Center cards, and they would show the preliminary matches from the Expo Center on television? They asked me before we went on the air. So, what was Bruiser's TV like? I said, imagine a wrestling TV show shot in 1953, except it's in color, and you would even with some of the same names, Bruiser and Snyder. The Expo Center cards, they'd have three preliminaries that were just meant to get guys over on TV, and then they'd show one of the main events. Then they'd do three more preliminaries and show another main event, and that would be two shows from the Expo Center. And every once in a while, like if the Gestapo death match,
Yeah.
no TV, no TV on this match,
Yeah,
right? But
yeah.
otherwise, he didn't do a studio show. He took that tape and sent it to the other markets in Indianapolis and Detroit, which we'll get to in a minute. It was basically, not only was it, you were asking the people in Indianapolis to pay to see just one maybe non-televised main event because everything else was going to be on TV, and then they'd run out of time. And it made me so mad when I was a kid because the main event
Did
was
you go
going.
and buy a ticket?
No, I couldn't. It was 120 miles away. But I'm tinkering with my rabbit ears, so I get this
That's
station
why you
in.
have these.
Every time there was a good main event, Dick the Bruiser versus Blackjack Mulligan, chain match. They just got him hooked up. They rang the bell. Folks, we're out of time. Went off the air, right? You didn't see it. You and Cowboy Bob Ellis for the WWA World Championship. They used to, because they did reruns too. That's another thing we'll talk about in a
I was
second.
going to say, because I wasn't there for the others.
You and Bob Ellis, they showed the same match, and I'm 12 now, right? They showed the same match probably 10 times one year, and it went off the air before the finish, but every time I watched it just to see if they would show a little more. I wasn't smart to TV at that point. But that TV show, the interviews made the show because the matches were, you got one competitive match and maybe not a finish, and the other ones were, But the interviews made the show, and that's where between yourself and Ernie Ladd and Bobby Heenan and the Blackjacks and the Valiant Brothers and Bruiser and Crusher and all those great promos, that's where the guys' personalities really got over.
Yeah.
That was the crux of the matter.